Suki Hayashi. Alright, I bought this from Tractor Parts Barn from Greer, South Carolina. Ordered this 3 days ago, and here I am. It's just afternoon on the third day, and I've got my saw. Alright, so what I'm supposed to have here is the saw, which is a four-part, three-extension pole saw, and this nice rigid plastic cover. So you can see it's all taped together for shipment. Let me take it apart, and it's supposed to be an owner's manual in here too, so let me cut it open and we'll take another look at it. Marketed as the best pole saw available on the market today. Made by the Silke Company. This saw is this is an 8-foot pole that extends to 21 feet. It's got a 15 1/4 inch blade, and the reach on this thing once it's fully extended will be 25 feet. So man, this handle, this thing is sturdy. Let me tell you, this whole thing, there's nothing, this doesn't give at all. This thing is sturdy, but it's not real heavy. I think the whole weight of this is a little under 7 pounds, a little over 7 pounds with the cover on the blade. It's made in Japan. I don't know if I said that already, but it looks like a samurai sword. And look at this handle, man. Holy cow. Okay. So, like I say, it extends from 8 foot to 21 foot. Let me put the blade on it, and then we'll extend it. So, let's take a look at this blade real quick. Oh yeah. It's a nice, nice heavy duty rigid blade cover comes with it. They've got a proprietary blade technology that they use. It's got, I think, like 5 1/2 teeth per inch and 4 rows of teeth. It's got a little sickle blade down here below and another one up top for cutting vines and small branches, I suppose. Okay, Silke uses this, what they call their dual locking system for the pole extension. It's got the locking clamps in addition to the locking pins, push pins here. So to extend a section, release the clamp and then push in the pin, and then that section can be extended. Then this pin pops into place and you clamp it down. So then it's solid. And all of the other sections work the same way. And then when you want to take it down, release the clamp, push the pin, pull it back in, push that pin in so it can get past this clamp, and then the pin pops back in place, lock your clamp down, and you're ready to store it. The whole saw stores inside this biggest pole. with the samurai grip. All right, looking forward to using this thing real soon. The only other thing I want to mention is I've now read the manual, and it teaches you how to operate the saw safely, but you could figure that out on your own. One thing it does point out is that you don't want to use these saws within 50 feet of electrical wires. So this could be important. Another feature of this thing, this blade could be adjusted two different angles for depending on higher or lower cutting. So I got, this is the default angle right here, but you can change it to a different angle for depending on your use. You've had the pole or the saw fully extended, and you want to bring it back in. You operate the clamps and pins in reverse order from extending the pole saw. There you have it. Back to 8 foot extending pole saw, which this is pretty good height by itself without even extending the blade. Like I said, it weighs 7 pounds, and when you have it fully extended, it doesn't seem really heavy and it's easy to control. So I'm looking forward to my first job with this thing. First job is this hackberry tree right back here behind me. Be my first job.
Walk with it a little bit and let you know what I think of it.
Always remember, safety first, boys and girls.
you go. After my first use of my new pulse saw, it's a winner, let me tell you. 5 stars all the way. This is sharp, sharp blade. I didn't even use these sickle blades, but they're sharp as razors. You can shave with those things. This thing is sturdy as it can be. That's all aluminum. And then your super good samurai grip. Makes it a lot easier job than it would have without it, I'll tell you that. It would have been 3 times the time and 10 times the work. So I'm very pleased with the saw. And if you have a use for something like this, get you one. The only downside to this thing at all, if there is one, is the cost. But you pay for quality, okay? I don't think I paid too much for it. I think it's worth every penny. It's Mondon out.